Good afternoon, everybody. My name is Dr. Reda Rakab. I'm an assistant professor at Mechanical Power Engineering Department at Zagzag University, Egypt. I'm introducing a poster titled Techno-Economic Assessment of a Wind Farm Repowering, a Case Study of Zafran Station, Gulf of Suez, Egypt. So the poster will have a couple of sections. The first section, I'm going to introduce about the introduction about the topic. And the second session talking about the approach that we followed in the optimal selection of the site and why we select the Zafran station itself for repowering. And the third section of the poster will talk about the site description, the characteristics of the wind profile at the site. And the fourth section will talk about the wind resource assessment calculations for the plant. And the final section will talk about the results and the conclusion. Talking about the first section, I'll talk about the introduction of the system. I'll say that it is important to define the end-of-life scenario. What we're going to do after the end-of-life of the wind turbine farm is necessary to define the possible scenario in order to avoid any unnecessary costs. So there are three common end-of-life scenarios that are normally used. The first one is dismantling or decommissioning. Just after the surface life of the project, we just remove the turbines and clear the site. The second scenario is the refurbishment, or you just change the major component of the wind turbine components and the generators and the control systems. And the third scenario is the repowering, where you replace old wind turbine generators with a newer, bigger, and more efficient one to harvest more energy. And this allows for better using of the existing infrastructure of the site and the source itself. So the wind farm repowering has many advantages. It may include increased annual energy production due to the improved performance. A higher efficiency and lower noise of the newer turbine makes this increased annual energy production. Also, higher hub heights of the newer turbines make it possible for turbine diameter for larger turbine diameters and also increased annual energy production. Better micrositing techniques available currently makes good estimate of the wind resource. And finally, the environmental impact of newer wind turbine is greatly reduced. Because they are lower in number, and that reduces the avian mortality, the visual impact, and improves the land use. In the present work, we performed a techno-economic study to evaluate the profitability of repowering the Zafran station at the Gulf of Suez, Egypt. We judged the profitability of the project using some economic indices like internal rate of return and the discounted payback period. And the calculation will show that the Zafrana repowering scenario is profitable, as we'll see. The approach used to select the optimum site is four criteria that should be available at the site in order to be built for the repowering scenario. The first one is the site with the highest wind resource. The second criteria is consideration of site constraints, like permissible tip heights, terrain topography, extra. And the third is the proper selection of the turbine with generation care that matches the site wind characteristic. This matching between the turbine generation curve and the site wind characteristics will allow the turbine to extract the maximum possible wind energy from the site. And this will depend, as we said, on the turbine characteristics and on the site characteristics. The turbine characteristics, like the cut-on, cut-out speed, and the site characteristics is judged also using a parameter called velocity ratio that we will define soon. The last criteria is the highest capacity credit, means the positive correlation between the grid curve and the plant generation curve. This allows the plant capacity to be possibly used to contribute during the peak time of the system to replace the low efficiency gas turbine peakers. So high capacity credit plant means that it generates energy at the time of peak hours. So it allows the system operator to use renewable energy from this plant instead of using the low efficiency gas turbine peakers. That in turn reduces the cost of electricity generated from the site. The velocity ratio as a measure of the degree of matching between the turbine performance and the site conditions is ratio containing the cutout ratio, the cutout speed of the turbine, the mean velocity of wind at the site, and the cut-in speed of the turbine. So higher wind ratio means higher velocity ratio means there's a good matching between the turbine and the site. Here, the site description will talk about why the Zafarana site is selected, because it matches the four criteria that are mentioned here. So we find that the site, if we looked at the map of the site of Zafarana here, we find that the Zafarana wind farm is located at the Gulf of Suez, which is a windy area in Egypt, has an average wind speed of 9.5 meters per second, which means high good potential of wind. The Zafarana wind farm built on phases over a period of 10 years from 2001 to 2010. First of all, there was no master plan for the construction of the plant, and they used the technology at that time. No master plan means that the sum of the phases of the plant was not well optimized, and thus the output of the site is not well optimized. And the technology available at the time was from 500 to 850 kilowatt per turbine, and the height was limited to around 50 meters. This causes the low capacity factor of the site compared to today's technology. Hence, better utilization of the wind resource can be achieved using today's mature technology, as well as optimal matching between the site and the turbine. The current capacity of Zafarana is 545 megawatt, and the capacity factor is 29%. So the current tip height limit is 100 meters set by the Ministry of Defense, while the turbines already in site are less than this limit. So there is a major potential for the improvement of the resource at the site. So this why repowering Zafarana is a good choice to improve capacity factor and capacity credit. Here in the map of the Zafarana layout, we have, I say, eight plants built sequentially from the year 2001 to 2010. No master plan was used, so some plants are shadowing the other plants, and the site is not well optimized to optimally use, extract the maximum possible amount of energy. Here is the characteristics at the site. This is the elevation map at the site. And here is the wind velocity distribution with average around 9.5 meters per second at 24 meters. And here is the wind drone shows that prevailing wind direction is uniquely from north. This is very important in design of the wind turbine, as it allows the easiness of design of the yaw mechanism of the and the control of the turbine. The next part of the next section of the poster talking about the wind resource assessment, we use two industry standard software for the wind resource assessment, namely WASP and RedScreen. WASP will be used to precisely optimize the turbine locations, because it has a micro-siting algorithm that is used to maximize the energy yield and hence reduce cost of energy. And this is done through the resource map, as we will show later. RedScreen has a built-in financial model that is used to judge the economic feasibility of the repowering project and give us the economic indicators that shows that the project is viable. Two scenarios are considered. Case one, which we're going to stick to the design tip height limit of 100 meters as set by the Army. And the case two is slightly relaxing the tip limit of the turbine to 125 meter, which allows more power extraction and hence increases the capacity factor. Two megawatt turbines module were used with diameters 80 and 90 meters, and were tested for the maximum annual energy production at hub heights of 60 and 80. This is the first turbine, and this is the annual energy production at that turbine, and this is the capacity factor, and this is the second turbine, which is the annual energy production and capacity factor. We compare the output of WASP to the output of RedScreen so that we can judge the performance of two softwares, and we see the results almost the same, means that the wind resource assessment is very robust model. There are three parameters that will affect the performance of the newly tested turbine. Here, comparing this turbine number two to turbine number one, we have different diameters that allow more energy to be harvested. The tip height of this turbine is higher than the tip height of this turbine by 25 meters, which means more energy also. The velocity ratio of the second turbine is increases by 46% with respect to the first turbine, which also means better matching between the wind profile and the turbine characteristics, and that will enhance the capacity factor and increase the annual energy production. Here is a sample of the calculation performed by WASP. This is called the WASP resource map that shows the annual energy production calculated at each turbine. From here, we see that the north direction, the wind is coming from the north direction. And using this map, WASP make a micro-siting, make micro-siting for the turbine. Micro-siting, the MATLAB checks or marks the turbines with the lowest efficiency or the highest wake losses, and it starts to manually change the position of the turbines to improve its performance so that the overall performance of the map of the wind farm is maximized. This is called micro-siting and is well done through the WASP software. So coming to the results of the calculations, we have here the net annual energy production from the two cases compared to the base case. This is the base case, 1400 gigawatt hour, and the second case with turbine limit, with tip height limit, 100 meter, is produced 3000 gigawatt hour, and relaxing the tip height to 125 meters produces 4,592 gigawatt hour for the whole farm. The financial output from this screen here, in the base case for the currently existing scenario, the turbines are very short, small diameters, around 50 meter diameter. The hub height is around 50 meter. The tip height is less than 100 meters. This is why the capacity factor is 29%, and the annual energy production is 1,400 gigawatt hour. The total installed capacity is 545 megawatt. For case one, if we increase the tip height to the tip height to 100 meter, so the wind velocity ratio will improve to increase to 52%. This enhances the matching between the site and the turbine, so the capacity factor is increasing by 45%, increasing to 45% instead of 29%, and the annual energy production is 3,008, which is 115%. So the capacity factor, the total installed capacity will be 750 megawatt. The increase in capacity factor will be 58% compared to the 29, and the increase in annual energy production is 115% compared to the 1400. So the electricity export rate will drop from the current situation to $67 per megawatt hour. For case two, if we relax at the height to 125 meters, we will have the velocity ratio improved to 76%. The capacity factor will be 69, almost 70%. The annual energy production will be 4,500 gigawatt hour, and the capacity will be 750. The capacity factor will increase by 141% compared to the base case, and the annual energy production will jump to 228% compared to the base case as well. This will reduce the electricity export rate from 67 to 48 dollar per megawatt hour. The conclusions, we find that from the calculation that the repowering of Zafarana with new turbine with characteristics better matching with the site condition as seen from the higher velocity ratio and optimizing the micro-siting procedure can increase the installed capacity from the current situation of 545 to 750 megawatt. The repowering of Zafarana plant at a tip height of 100 meters is economically feasible. We knew that by calculating the annual internal rate of return of 14% with discounted by payback period of 8 years. However, this feasibility shall improve if we relax the tip height to 150, 125 meters instead of 100 meters. Improvement in capacity factor and consequently, annual energy reduction causes the cost of generated energy after discounting the potential loss of energy of the phased out plant, because we have some plants that is withstand the 20 years. If we even scrap this amount and discounted the amount of the energy that can be produced from them, we still have improvement in the capacity factor, and the cost of generated energy will drop down from 67 to 47.5 US dollar per megawatt hour, calculated at internal rate of return 14%. Improving capacity credit from 18% to 42% for the repowered plant at 125 tip height leads to additional reduction in the cost of electricity generation down to $40 per megawatt hour at IRR of 14%. The visibility of the repowering project shall improve definitely. Note, the capacity credit 40% means that 40% of the plant capacity will be possible to contribute during the peak time of the system. Means the 750 megawatt plant can share with 300 megawatt in the peak load, and this is why the capacity credit improves to from 18% of the current situation to 42% at KISTO, and this drops the electricity price to $40 per megawatt hour. And that's the conclusion of the work, that Zafarana repowering is profitable at the current situation. And that's the final conclusion. Thank you so much, and ready for your questions.